Hey everyone, it's Amy Astro here and welcome back to my channel. We're going to continue moving on with this RASA, but today's topic is going to be back focus. How we're going to calculate it and where does the back focus start? So let's get going. Focus is one of those interesting topics that you hear of a lot. Now, I'm used to back focus talking about a refractor, and you know, my field flattener or reducer would be having a 55 millimeter back focus requirement, and I had to create that number with spacers all the way up to the end of my camera. And the goal of a good back focus is so that all the stars in your image are nice and sharp corner to corner. Now, as we've learned before, that if the camera is tilted slightly in one direction or the other, you start getting the elongation of the stars in the corners. So you really need to have a combination of a good back focus and making sure all of your planes are perfectly equal with each other, you know, perpendicular and such, so you don't get those tilts in some of your stars. But let's talk about back focus with the RASA. Now, the RASA has a back focus per their manual of 29 millimeters. Now, if you look at, they've got another page on their website, which I'll show you shortly, that shows you how you can make your own camera adapter, and they recommend a very particular back focus of 28.73 millimeters. So it sounds like we have a 0.25 millimeter gap approximately between the two. So you just got to work it out to see what works best for you. Now, to get started with your back focus calculation, you need to know the back focus of your camera. Now, I am using the ZWO ASI 1600 Pro Cool version, and that has a back focus of 6.5 millimeters. And I got that from the manufacturer's spec page. Now, this is the ring that I'm going to use for my camera. It is an adapter plate that was included with the RASA and is meant for a 42 millimeter camera front. Now, from this back edge here to the end of my camera, where the sensor is underneath the window when you look at it, that needs to add up to 29 or 28.73 millimeters. Now, I'll be honest, getting that particular is tricky. So I would need to go out and get enough spacers and make sure that they mount up to this M42 to equal out the 28.73. Now, I didn't have enough spacers in my drawer to accomplish that at all. So it meant I had to go shopping. So I could go shopping for a different spacer, I needed some really small spacers to accomplish that, or I could move forward with my plan of using a filtered drawer. So what I did is I went to Starzona. Now, Starzona makes a filter drawer that is specific to the RASA 8, meaning they already did the math for us. So when I connect this camera adapter plate to the filter slider, it will equal near exactly what I need for my back focus. And when I did it all, it worked out that I needed one extra component to make this as perfect as I possibly can. And that is one of these little plastic gaskets that come with the ZWO camera. So I put this up against the camera face and I mount my camera to one side, and when I get it all installed on the front, I attach this camera adapter, and that will equal out the back focus that I need. But let me show you how to get it all installed. Now, when you get the RASA from the factory, it comes with a glass plate over the corrector, okay? Now, I need to remove this glass plate because I'm gonna put a filter in the stream a little bit higher. Now, some folks have suggested leaving this in, but per the manual from Celestron, they say remove this, okay? So I'm going to remove this little plain glass filter that they put in. Okay, so I'm gonna remove this and set it aside for later. And I'm gonna remove this retaining ring that comes on the telescope. All right, so this is the retaining ring that holds everything together. So I'm gonna take the adapter plate that they gave me and I'm gonna insert it inside this retaining ring and I'm gonna thread it onto the telescope. Now be careful to keep everything nice and perpendicular with the optics because this is the step that if I don't get this flush, then I will start getting some elongation of the stars in the corners. Okay. So I don't want to go crazy tight because I don't want to crack the glass. That would be a bad thing to do. Okay. And I want to make sure this is really nice and secure in here. Now I'm going to take the time and clean out any dust that could be back here because I don't want any dust bunnies in my image train because that just means more work when I'm processing the images. Next, we're going to take the Starzona filter holder slider drawer, which on the inside is where I would put my filter. And you see it has this nice little magnet touch so it's not going to fall out. Has a little handle for you to grab onto things. And don't worry, this is not going to cause any problems in your image train. It's not gonna block any light, so this is really good. Now, what they say to do is to install it so the Starzona is upright. Now, it took me a little while to figure that out because is upright, which direction really is? But they're talking about if this telescope was tilted up to the sky. You wanted to be able to read the Starzona. So I've got it upright right now, and I am going to attach it to the camera adapter. All right, there it is. And my filter holder, slider, drawer, whatever you want to call it, comes out nice and easy. Now, the benefit of this is I could have a filter in here for my one-shot colors that will help me get nebulosity, or I could set up multiples of these drawers off to the side with my LRGB or my narrow bands and have them all set up ready to go, which was really quite nice. So I don't have to sit there and thread on all my filters all the time. I can have them stacked up off to the side, ready to go. Now Starzona sells these drawers here and I've got mine all attached. They just kind of slide in together, but you can have them all sitting here. So I open it upside down. You can have them all sitting here off to the side, ready to go. There you go. It's just a little jiggling to get it in there, but it is really nice. And it's a safe way to carry all your filters. I planned ahead and I wanted to have narrow bands. So I will put my HA, my oxygen 3, and my sulfur 2 in these. And when I use my one-shot color camera, I will have the HA, H beta, the oxygen 3 filter that Celestron sent with the kit for me. So let's get this mounted in here. All right, so here's the filter that Celestron sent me. And to begin with, I'm going to use my one-shot color camera. And it's always nice to get started with a one-shot color camera. It helps simplify things at the very beginning until you get to know things. Okay. So here is my filter. Now I've got my filter drawer and I am going to just set that inside. All right, so let me walk back just a little bit. I was gonna take the filter drawer from Starzona. And I was gonna install the filter that I received from Celestron. It's their H-alpha, H-beta, oxygen 3 filter. But It is slightly larger than the standard 2-inch filter. This filter was specifically intended to fit inside the Celestron body. So this means if I want to use this filter, I'm going to have to put it back into the body of the telescope, and I will use these filter sliders another day and just keep this unit on to accomplish my back focus. Okay, so that's what's happened with this one. But what I did do is I verified that with the standard 2-inch filters, it does fit perfectly in the Starzona filter holder. Okay, so this would be your L Pros, your tri-band filters. Those type of filters will work great with the filter drawer. Now, they do have adapters for these if you wanted to knock them down to 1¼. I don't think 1¼ is a great idea for the RASA. I would probably stick with the 36 millimeter, but Starzona has planned ahead for the standard size filters. And I'm not really sure why the Celestron one doesn't fit that way. Now, what I did see on the Celestron one, which was really quite neat, was there was two rings on this and they had little notches in them. And when I removed the inside ring, the lens actually popped out and now it was an unmounted filter. But I didn't have a way to attach it into these threads. So I'm gonna have to figure this one out and I'll get back to you guys in a later video to find out what I discovered. So let me show you on the computer the specs and where I got all my information from so you believe me. I mean, come on, I gotta back my data up with proof. So let's go to the computer. All right, everybody, we're over here on the computer and I'm on Celestron's website and I am on their product page for the 8-inch RASA telescope. And if we scroll down in this here, we have a section called specifications. And in the specifications, it tells us everything we need to know about this particular telescope. And right here, back focus from the top of the threaded collar. This is how I accomplished it. So that's 29 millimeters. Now, if you come over here to, where is it? Support and downloads. They have some other items here. You can get their manual if you have lost it for some reason, but they've got this camera adapter requirement, which is really cool because this is for you guys who like to use a 3D printer and you want to make your own adapter for some special type camera. They give you the full dimensions on how to build this, but over here, on the right side, the adapter that they gave me has a 3.5 millimeter minimum distance space right here. So I measured from the thickness of this all the way to the front of my camera sensor. And this part right here from the sensor plane here is 6.5 millimeters. So I just had to make up the difference here. And that is when I went and used the Starzona filter slider, and it's specifically made for the RASA 8. Now we can scroll down here and they tell us in here that, now here it says the optical window in the RASA 8 will stay in place. But let me go back to, there we go, the manual itself. Okay, it talks about removing the optical window here, and it says if using a filter somewhere in the light path or if the camera has an optical window, it is recommended to remove the optical window in the lens group cell, and this maintains the best optical performance. So I'm going with what Celestron is telling me, and I have removed that glass from the telescope, and I will only use filters from there out to be, you know, I guess to be my filters. But this is where I got that information. It is from their manual. Now you do want to make sure that you keep everything here as flush as you can and perpendicular to the entire optical train. We don't want any elongation of stars. Okay, but I thought it was really kind of neat that they gave us the drawings for you guys to build them in your Tinkercads and stuff to do a 3D printout of everything. All right, guys, so that's what I've got for you today, the basics of back focus and why it's important and how we accomplish back focus on the RASA 8. So I hope you guys like that video. Don't forget to like, subscribe, share with all your astro friends. And what I announced last week is I want to see your astro pets in my videos. So send me an email with your astro pet, okay? And I'll add them to the end of the videos for the whole world to see. But guys, you know, thank y'all for everything. Thank you for watching and hanging with me. And I look forward to seeing you guys in the next video. So, great health, clear skies. I love each and every one of y'all. Goodbye.